program created by Rio Grande.
That was this old sheriff's office calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 267 regarding a holdup. Assist the officer. That's all. Roll the
December, I ask you, friends of Calling All Cars, to help us in the test of listener loyalty to this program by making at least one call at the Rio Grande station. And now the sponsor, the cast, and I thank you for your generous demonstration of loyalty that carried the test to a most successful conclusion. In appreciation, we will bring you 52 of the best Calling All Cars programs that it's been our privilege to produce, and to continue to make available to you the finest petroleum products money can buy. Believe me when I say, and you can prove it to yourself, Real Lube is the finest motor oil sold in the West. It is made so strong that it cannot break down under the intense heat of your fastest speed. And what is equally phenomenal, Real Lube never is slowed up by the coldest weather. Newly won friends are always happily surprised to learn that this great motor oil costs only 25 cents a quart in dirt-proof, dilution-proof tanks. Real Lube has to be good to be the running mate of Rio Grande Crack, a gasoline that powers more police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment wherever it is sold than any other brand. Remember to get some tomorrow. As an example of the splendid cooperation existing between law enforcement bodies, San Francisco City and County are outstanding. We have therefore asked William D. Hollingbetter, Under Sheriff to Sheriff Daniel C. Murphy of San Francisco County, to open our program from the studios of KSFO.
The work done by the police officers in tonight's story was still an extensive file. It is a simple example of the unsung efforts of those men who have sworn to uphold the law, and of the seldom exploited achievements of the policemen of San Francisco. In the words of Chief Quinn of the San Francisco Police Department, this story is one of the behind-the-scenes labor, pieced together like a never-ending puzzle. The labor that traps the burglar, catches the swindler, and brings punishment to the pickpocket, the shoplifter, the bad check artist, the petty thief, and all those other swarming creatures of the underworld, whose crimes are in too significant to make the headlines. This is the story of a kind that police departments throughout the country are faced with every day. It is a story of the kind of work that is every day convincing criminals that crime is a losing proposition.
Club in San Francisco, two men watch one of the dancers.
What are we waiting over here for? Come on up to the bar and have a drink.
Now, wait a minute. Let's go in a hole like that.
Oh, why wait? It ain't stopping me, and it won't stop anything unless you get to another face in a different state.
Now, listen, Mars. Don't talk about my girl that way.
Oh, no, girl. Oh, well, maybe she just needs a new foot.
Nah, it's just lousy orchestra. Don't give her nothing. Boy, I can just see her among them swinging farms of Goonie Goonie.
Well, she's doing all right among the swinging stews right here.
Oh, that's just it. I'm going to take her away from all this.
Yeah? The Goonie Goonie?
No, no. She ain't a real Hawaiian. She just made up that way.
Oh, yeah?
Pipe down. Here she comes. Now, remember, she thinks I'm a big shot.
Hello, Freddy. Well, it was some girl she was doing. She fought to a picture of
her. Oh, I bet that picture stays in all the girls. Anyway, I'm pleased to meet you.
What's she doing tonight, honey?
I'm nothing much. Well, I gotta get dressed. See you later.
Oh, this is something. I do plenty for that game.
Yeah, there's plenty other guys doing things for her. Maybe she's good. She's got a husband that would do a few things for you.
She's got a husband. but that don't matter, man.
Yeah, sure. You're a big shot, huh? Too big, you can't prove it.
Oh, yeah? Maybe I am going to prove it. This happens and I'm all ready to do some jobs and dig it out of this town. And take that with me. You won't even know where I got the money.
Just like that, huh? What about her husband? Well, where are you going to get the gun? Oh, where'd you get a special permit from the company?
Ah, the cops in this town are too dumb to worry me. We can make monkeys out of
them. Yeah, they look like it if we get stuck in one of their monkey cages.
Listen, we gotta catch it first. We ain't got no record here in Frisco.
Okay, you'll do anything to get that disguise. But when are you gonna get a ride?
What does this look like?
Yeah, it's like a toy picture.
That's just what it is. I got it at the five and dime store. But it won't look like a toy when I get done painting it black.
You think it'll work?
Of course it'll work. Stay kind of in the background and you wave that pig stick of yours under that suit. You're too scared to look at the gun twice.
Okay, I'm with you. But there's only one angle I don't like.
What's that?
Big pickup business and strikes don't miss. Not even hula strikes. They say nothing of a married hula strike.
That's a joke. We don't know what it's all about.
Well, I hope some little boy don't come.
We'll give the bird to the cop. Come on. Let's try out our toy gun and see how it works.
Shortly after midnight on October 23rd, 1937, Morris Potter was behind the desk of the Almond Hotel on 80th Street. As he glanced up from his ledger, two men entered the lobby.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Room with a double bed.
Yes, sir. Just stand right here and I'll see what we've got.
Well, what price did you want?
We ain't particular. Just give us everything you got.
You mean anything I've got?
We mean everything, buddy. This is a sticker.
What? Yeah, come on, get that case door open, or maybe my partner will slit your throat.
Yeah, we don't want to waste no shot on you. So don't stand me. Or get that knife out of my wrist.
Go on, quick, shot it.
There isn't much here.
Give us the silver, too.
Listen. Here it is.
Okay. Now, you've been a good boy so far, but...
Yeah, but if you don't keep quiet, my partner will come back in and slit you.
Yes, sir.
Twenty-four hours later, almost to the minute, outside a hotel on 4th Street.
Is there anybody in the lobby?
No, just a clerk behind the desk.
Let's go.
Wait a minute. What if one of these here clerks gets stuck? That short gun of yours ain't loaded, you know?
Ah, they're all too yellow. They get twisty. Just hit them with that pig sticker of yours.
Okay, but if I start running, they'll go get in me way.
Don't you worry. I'll be too far in front of you. Let's go. Pick him up, fella.
Yeah, keep your trap shut if you don't want this knife in your wrist.
No, he's doing good sense. Come on, quickly pick him, buddy. It'll all be over in a few minutes.
Yeah, we won't hurt you if we have to.
Kind of made me feel bad, you know, to plug that last guy that thought he was so brave.
You know, I felt bad, too. Maybe he had a wife and kid. He died awful quick. Maybe there ain't much going at this roof.
That's okay. We don't want to be greedy. As long as this guy's acting so nice about it, even his smart buddy.
Yeah. It's a thing you got in a nervous trigger finger. I think he wants to have a good cry. That's good.
No, he ain't gonna cry. No. Not a big man like him. He's just going to have a little fainting spell.
Yeah, we'll call it doctor for him when we get far, far away.
Inspectors George O'Leary and William McMahon of the robbery detail made routine investigations. No clues as to the identity of the member discovered. Then, 4 weeks later, a deluge of small hotel robberies confronted the police. On the night of November 23rd, at the Hotel Barney on Jones Street, two men entered the lobby.
I see by this little tag on your desk that your name's Robert Brown.
That's right, gentlemen. What can I do for you?
You can do just as we tell you, or get a dose of lead poison.
Well, what do you want?
What does that door lead to?
That's fine, because that's just where you're going, Mr. Brown.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm going to lock you down there in the basement in one piece, I hope.
What do you mean?
I mean I'm going to cut you up in little pieces and leave you down there if you decide to get frisky.
Oh, no, no. I won't do anything.
If you go, it'll be your last piece. Here, there you go. Let's see, you have a tight on mouth. Have you got the dope, Bob?
Yeah, all I can get. Starve down there before somebody finds him, do you?
What if he should?
We don't want to do anything to make the cops mad at him.
I guess you're right. But to think what is getting kind of monotonous. Isn't it monotonous? Yeah, it's kind of.
You was the guy that was afraid it wouldn't work.
It's just so easy. Let's go stick up another joint.
And I don't get so anxious for you. We got to lay low until tomorrow night.
Yeah. night, at the very moment Robert Brown was being interviewed by officers at the Hotel Congress almost around the corner, Harry Drury was mutely standing with hands in the air.
He ain't very sociable, mister.
Yeah, but he'd say something if that there gun of yours went off.
That is the shot.
Yeah, gunshot. Yeah. Come on, let's get the money and go.
Now, wait a minute. You wanted some variety. Get that rope over there and tie his hands up.
Do you want anything to be different?
Real thoughtful of him to have a rope already and waiting for us.
Quick, was it just? Buzz your hands, Jeff, buddy.
Okay.
Well, you'll be using them to climb up the golden ladder.
Don't climb up so the cops can't figure out how to untie when they get here.
Oh, wouldn't that be terrible?
Ow.
Yes, Jeff. Yeah, that'll hold him for a while. What'll I do with him now?
Put him right down behind the counter.
Down you go, buddy. He's talking so much. Maybe he ought to jazz him.
Ah, no. You'll find his tongue when the cops get here. Come on, let's go.
I almost wish somebody'd walk into one of these big lobbies when we're doing a job. Just to see what would happen.
Oh, it's just our luck. Besides, if something like that happens, I might need a real gun.
Hey, listen to that so-called hotel.
We ain't paid a visit to this hotel before, have we?
No, the name just don't happen to appeal to me.
How many times have I told you we can't be choosy in our line of business?
Well, the place looks awful deserted. Maybe they'd be glad to have our business. Hey, did you bring that rope with you?
Yeah, but anybody going by in the street could see us tying him up. We'll have to take him upstairs.
I hope we get enough out of it to make it worth our trouble. Let's go.
You got a room on the second floor?
Oh, yes, indeed, gentlemen. If you'll just sign here,
yes, take a look at the room first.
Certainly. Just come this way, please.
Just keep walking and don't make any noise. This is a gun in your room.
A gun? What are you going to do?
I'm going to look at the room.
And if you try any funny stuff, it'll be the last room you ever showed anybody.
But I don't have any money. It's all in the cash register.
Yeah, thanks for reminding us, bud. We'll stop up for it on the way out.
Yeah, after we've taken care of you.
Taking care of my
sister. What do you mean? You'll find out and make sure the room you show us is empty.
Yes, sir, but why?
Go on, go on. Open the door and don't ask no questions.
Yes, sir.
Now, listen, buddy. It'd be bad for the hotel's reputation if somebody got knocked off of this joint, wouldn't it?
Knocked off?
Yeah.
Knocked off?
Yeah, that's just what's going to happen to anybody that squeals to the cops, eh?
You wouldn't dare.
No, we wouldn't. Maybe you'd like to see you show you. Like this.
No, don't. Oh, stop it now. You...
I ought to shove your face into the floor just for good measure.
Go ahead. Time up. Don't waste any time on it.
Okay, but it'll be a lot easier to pretty throw.
No,
messy with you. Let's out of here. I'll just squat you.
If he gets his lily white wrist out of this here nut, boy, he'll be a Houdini.
No, that hurts.
Shut up. I told you I'd like to have it.
Give him a couple of slugs in his stomach. Maybe you like him better than his two
rules. No, don't you.
Now, let's get one more up out of you, and it'll be your last one.
I wish I'd brought some more rope. I like to hang him by his feet from that there chimney.
Hang it up that post. That's good enough.
Okay, move over.
I can't.
Move over. I'll kick you over. Come on. Hold your feet
still.
Yeah,
that better be some real money in that cash register, or we'll come back and give you a good working over.
Yeah, nothing makes me madder than to go to a lot of trouble like this and just bring nothing. Yeah, that ought to do him.
Come on, we've wasted too much time on this rope already.
Remember, buddy, one yelp body will come back and make a mess out of you on that there rug. That's all right, Brown. We've got nothing else to do until tomorrow night.
Sir, Mr. Sullivan registered in this hotel.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Sullivan.
No, there's nobody with that name here, John.
Oh, that's all right. Just open up the cash drawer and give us what you get.
And make it snappy. We're in a hurry tonight.
Yes. Well, $65 is all I have.
That's all right. Don't apologize. Good night, guys.
Good night.
How you doing with a bullet shot, Bob?
Oh, well. He knows I'm a big shot now.
Yeah, but you know how you're getting all this, Jack?
No. You never will know. And neither will the cops.
Meantime, at police headquarters, Captain of Inspector Dallaire calls a conference with Inspectors McMahon and Gus.
I've told you fellows in here for a little conference on this hotel battery situation. I've pulled four jobs in the last 4 days, six all told. It's beginning to give me a headache.
Me too. Who do those guys think they are? Jesse James II?
I don't care who they think they are. I'm interested in who we think they are. You got any ideas, Bud?
I think they're just a couple of punks that have been lucky for
them. They're amateurs, all right. They walk in and out of a hotel in plain sight of anybody that might be going by and leave fingerprints all over the place.
Yeah, fingerprints that we have no record of in the file.
That's just it.
They're smart enough to know that we can't get along on them in the usual ways.
Oh, I don't know. Only a couple of stats that think they were smart to get us away with stuff like this.
And we've checked prisons up and down the coast for parole, discharged convicts. We've got no lead from that. Every hotel clerk in San Francisco has complete descriptions of them. We've got patrol cars in the downtown hotel district looking for them.
It's 20 years, all right. We know what they look like, how they work, and everything about them except who they are.
Well, they'll pull a bone sooner or later. That'll give us a lead on them. They always do.
Oh, we'll get them, but I'm afraid they'll walk into a hotel some night, get into a jam, and start shooting.
That knife doesn't be a funny angle. Why don't they both use guns? Doesn't make sense.
And as soon as they start operating in a way that makes sense, we'll have them.
Well, if they're as dumb as I think they are, they're going to pull a lot of jobs first.
Well, the more jobs, the sure we are to get them. But I'd sleep a lot better tonight if I knew where they are right now.
Hey, Red. The hula dancer looks kind of tired tonight, Bob. She dances like she's only got a couple of more years. She takes in it.
Yeah, I know. She ain't putting her soul in.
Maybe she's homesick for that day of 2020.
No, that ain't it. This dive is getting her down.
Listen. I thought we were going to get a second. Clear out of this here town. Well, what do you do? You spend it all on a busy hula school.
Can I help it if I'm in love? Hey, Graham, this is something I want to talk to
you. Don't worry, I'm going, but I'm telling you, you're going to get an edge on account of that switch.
Graham, will you?
Hi,
Big Joe. Hiya, baby. Come on over here. Hey, you look all in, honey.
Yeah. This joint's getting me down.
Yeah, I know how it is. I try to say, like, you ought to be in a more uplifting joint than this.
Oh, you say the sweetest thing. No wonder I'm nuts about you.
No kidding, Ray. Are you?
Sure I am. But how can I tell you in a dump like this? Why, every time a guy buys a drink, he thinks up late in my grass skirt could go with it.
That's what I want to talk to you about.
What, the grass skirt?
Oh, no. I'm an honorable guy. I want to take you away from all this. I do things in a big way. With me, it's the whole or nothing.
You're still talking about the skirt?
Ah, quit your kidding. Let's me and you get out of this town.
But what about Clarence, my husband?
Oh, nuts to Clarence.
Oh, now, Bob, I wouldn't do nothing to hurt Clarence. He's a nice guy.
Oh, he's a nice guy.
But he ain't a big shot.
Okay, what are you going to do?
Well, Clarence has talked about getting some money together so he could go to Oregon.
Ah, think nothing more of it, babe. I'll throw enough dough in his lap to pay him to Alaska. It'll take me a couple of weeks, but he's good as done.
Gee, what a guy. What's your line anyhow, Bob?
Oh, I'm in the hotel business. I go from one to another and sort of give the clerk a little going over, you know.
What do you mean?
Well, they don't know me, see. They think I'm a customer. So I check up on them. You see, they don't get sassy or out of line like that.
That's a swell job.
Yeah, I can transfer to Chicago just like that.
Well, I'm with you if you can get Clarence to give me the okay.
Now, listen, babe. I'm a very persuasive guy. I got a style all my own. Oh, that reminds me. I got to do some work yet tonight.
Okay. I'll be seeing you, Big Shot.
Goodbye, honey.
In the next few days, four hotels and a drugstore were looted by the same bandits. Then, on November 30th, Albert Cannon, night clerk at the Apex Hotel, was reading a police circular describing the bandits as two men approached. Recognizing them, his hand went to a legal automatic hidden beneath the desk.
Evening, gentlemen. Wish to register?
Yeah, what's this? This is a stick-up.
Come on, get out of here.
Yeah? Well, what does this look like?
I'll bite you. I'll do that for you. I cracked your skull, wise guy.
Yeah, take this, Jack, and throw him, Bob.
No, it makes too much noise. Give me a hand and we'll lock him in that closet.
Okay. Boy, that was a close case. It's a lucky thing for lucky. Guns in the fire.
Yeah, the safety catch must have been on.
I called. You're one of those clerks who get pushed some nights.
Well, from now on, we'll have this automatic to talk back to him with. Come on, jump him in there.
Okay. Let's get the don't get out of here, right? We need a drink.
Yeah, me too, and I feel a lot easier not having to depend on a toy gun anymore.
With nine consecutive holdups that left the city gas cabin of Inspector Zelaya again conferred with a dozen members of the robbery detail.
The available facts were analyzed and showed the opposition specialist McMahon and Fred Butt were speeding across town.
Your hunch is right about these merchants getting bloodthirsty.
Yeah. Next time it's liable to be murder. Good store they stuck up. Just a hunch, but it may lead to something.
Well, that was funny. 16 hotel stick-ups and one drugstore.
When a thug gets out of his regular line, he usually makes a slip. I certainly hope his drugstore job was it.
And don't we all? Well, here's Big Street. The store is right around the corner.
Right in a small hotel district. Mm.
A little place. Sure don't go after anything big.
Yes, sir?
We're from headquarters. We'd like to know if you can tell us anything about the men that held you up besides what you gave us in the report.
Well, let me see now. You know, there was something queer about those two that I forgot to mention.
Yeah? What was that?
Why, those fellas had been in the store several times before. I sure was surprised when they pulled a gun on me.
Maybe they were looking the place over.
No, I don't think so. A couple of times they seemed to come from across the street. I figured they were living near here.
Well, across the street. This was the slip they made, Fred. Come on, we're going to check every hotel in this block.
I've been waiting for this.
Fred, I think our hotel bandits have pulled their last job. I'm going to ask Chief Quinn for 100 men to cover every hotel in the district.
Do you think they'll shoot it out?
I almost hope they'll try to. Robbery detail, McMahon speaking. Oh, hello, Merrick. Any of the boys had any luck?
At what?
Registered there in the same name? Stick there. We'll be right over.
I bet there are more coppers in this hotel than our guests.
We've been here over an hour. We hope they don't decide to change hotels again. Wait a minute.
Regent Hotel? Yes, I'll give him the message.
Is that one of them?
Yes. I don't know which one. He left a message for his partner.
What was it?
Meet me at the Blue Grotto.
Blue Grotto, that's a nightclub over on Mason Street. Come on, Fred. So you're the hostess here at the Blue Grotto. Do you recognize the descriptions we've given you?
Guys like that usually stick to one spot. They must have seen them out the time.
Well?
Come on. We've got nothing to lose.
Well, yes, I know them both. Tad Williams, one of our dancers here, is in love with Bob McGee.
Well, it'll be a break for her to find out what kind of a guy he is.
Well, you're too late. Tad eloped with Bob to Chicago. They took the 9 o'clock ferry to Oakland to connect with the train.
It's 7 minutes after 9 right now. If we average 70 over the bridge, we'll meet the boat coming in. If we don't pick him up there, we'll be back. Back again, lady. What's the idea of giving us a bum steer like that? They weren't on the boat and they weren't on the train. You better quit stalling because if you're trying to protect
I'm
them...
I'm not. Honestly. That's what Pat told me.
Okay. Maybe they decided to spend their honeymoon here in San Francisco. Maybe they couldn't wait till they got to Chicago. Where does Pat Williams live?
She's been living with her husband.
Her husband?
No use looking for a honeymoon there.
Well, there's nothing else to do now but go visit the husband. Maybe he'll be willing to talk.
Did you ever see one that wouldn't?
Not yet.
He lives on the 900 block on Golden Gate Avenue. I don't know the exact number.
That's close enough. If we scare the guy enough, maybe he'll give us something to work on.
I told you those guys were dumb. I knew we'd turn into a triangle case. It never fails.
Trying to tell you, Clarence.
Pat and me are in love with each other. Can't you understand something like that?
So what? She's been in love with lots of guys, even me.
Oh, but this is different, Clarence.
Oh, yeah, it's always different.
You just don't understand, Clarence. Pat here has got a soul. She needs to be free. I want to see her in a joint where the guys will buy her champagne instead of rot-gut liquor.
Yeah, I'm sick of doing the hula. A fan dance is much more elegant.
A fan dance? You know what happened the one time you tried it.
Yeah, that's just it. The guys around that place is crude. They don't know no better.
Just right, Clarence. Bob and me want to go to Chicago and start life all new.
New? You mean all nude?
Oh, you see, Bob. Clarence just ain't got no appreciation of art.
Who's this art guy? That's...
Now, how do you like that? Well, maybe he's got some appreciation of this. You see these bills, Clarence?
Mm-hmm.
They're all 20s and 50s. How would you like it if they was all yours?
Say, that's real money. If it's not hot, how come you're messing around with my wife?
Hey, God, Pat. How can I talk to a guy that ain't used to associating with big guys?
Well, you just ain't ever seen that much money before. Give him a chance,
oh,
will you?
Okay, okay. Now, listen, Pat. I'll take it slow and easy. You wanted a stage to get to Oregon. Well, here it is. Now, what more do you want?
Well, that means I have to go up alone, huh? My wife don't go with me.
Well, what do you think I am, a Santa Claus?
Well, I'd hate to tell you what I thought you were.
Ah, now, wait a minute.
Don't get me off. You ain't gonna get to my place. Bob, you've got a big gun. He can do things for me.
Okay, I guess I know what I'm like.
Now, you're talking sense. This is the easiest show you ever made in your life.
Yeah, I guess it is, that. Well, if it hadn't been you, it would have been some other guy. I seen this coming.
Okay, here's the go. Pat, you and me are kept the late kind of proposal.
It's okay by me, big son.
That's probably my laundry.
What? Don't you know who's coming to see you?
Nobody ever comes to see me. They come to see Pat.
Nobody was coming to see me.
Pat, I know it is. I should have gone out of here long ago.
Get your hands up, everybody.
Pat!
You! Get out of here.
No, don't shoot me. Don't shoot.
All right, listen, Fred. Now, where's your partner, buddy? I've been looking for you for some time,
yeah? Right here.
Are you going to talk or aren't you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll talk.
There's a legal automatic, though. Fully loaded.
Uh-huh. Got that from the effects hotel clerk. So you were going to leave for Chicago tonight,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, yeah. When I seen the headline in the paper that said the cops was going to shoot to kill the hotel bandits, I got kind of scared.
Take a look at your big shot now, Pat.
Who are you?
All right. Well, I ain't no bad. I'm just half-tight.
Hey, they didn't have nothing to do with me and my brothers. They're just friends.
Yeah, officer. We were just casual acquaintances. I met Bob here in the nightclub, and he just sort of walked around.
Yeah, so we heard.
Well, where's your partner?
He's at the Black Hotel in Oakland. His name's Marvin Thomas.
Okay, Fred, take the boys and go get him.
Yeah, but what's going to become of me?
Well, dig out the grass, Kirk, sister. You've got just a half an hour to make that first show.
Moment, we shall hear the concluding facts of our story. Remember, friends, it is just as important to protect your motor as its power. And for maximum protection, use Real Lube motor oil. For maximum power, speed, getaway, and mileage, Rio Grande Crack, the most highly recommended gasoline sold in the West. Thomas was taken into custody in Oakland, and the two bandits were found guilty and sentenced to spend terms of 5 years to life in San Quentin, where they will learn most conclusively that crime does not pay.
San Francisco Sheriff's Office calling all cars, attention all cars, cancellation broadcast 267 regarding the holdup. The suspects are now in custody. That's all. Roll the road. Frederick Lindsley, bidding you good night for Rio Grande.
week at this time, Rio Grande will present Miss Helen DeHagen in The Case of the Silver Cord. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.